We are here in Chennai at the Novotel Chennai Subcourt. But I think it's cooked beautifully. I mean, this is the sort of fish that you just eat whole.
We've got a bounty of fish today.
There were two of my favorite seafood here. So there's carne and we just had shrimp.
It's all fresh. Makes a huge difference. Delicious. Having spent the morning fishing with Selvam, I was in for a special treat when he invited me home to savor some authentic fishing community preparations cooked by his sister-in-law, Mrs. Jayakanti. Red snappers, squids and prawns, there was a fair bit to be tasted, including a fishy staple that is a bit of an acquired taste. Dried fish or karuvadu, as his delicacy is referred to in Tamil.
When do you usually make dry fish? Is it made when there is not too much fish available?
இது வந்து கெட்டு போன மீன் கருவாடு.
Okay.
மீனை சேல்ஸ் பண்ண முடியாம இருந்துச்சுன்னா அதை திரும்ப கருவாடா போடுவோம்.
Okay, so the fish that is not sold. Gets
used. Not sold means you can put the salt and soak it in the sunlight.
Oh, okay.
You will dry for 2-3 days. After that, you use for dry fish.
All right. Great. So I'm really looking forward to this lunch here. It smells a lovely garlic. So this recipe is a family recipe for this prawn soup, okay? So where did she learn it from?
Whilst Mrs. Jayakanti was frying the red snapper and working on a prawn tukku that was already smelling delicious, my attention turned to the other dishes that were waiting to be tasted.
Dry fish gravy and with some vegetables, right? So I can see the drumsticks here, I can see radish. Is there also some brinjal in this? Potato as well. What fish is this?
Sea bass,
okay. And then next we have the squid. Beautiful. So what is the masala for this?
Melody.
Siragam.
Panjamalagattu. மஞ்சப்பொடி வெங்காயம் தக்காளி மிஞ்சி பூண்டு பேஸ்ட் கொத்தமல்லி தடவி இதுக்கு மிளகு சீரகம் போடுற லேயரா இருக்கு அதுக்கு
போடு. You know what I really like is the fact that it's got the complete squid, you know, from the head to the tail, and I think each part of the squid has a different flavor, different texture. Don't mind the drumstick. Thank you. You can taste the pungency of this fish.
It's big on flavors.
I think dry fish is certainly, it's not for the feeble palate. You need to really love your fish.
Yes.
I love the flavors of the drumstick. I think there's some tamarind in that dish. So the drumstick has the tamarind, you can taste the tartness. But you can also taste the fish in the drumstick. You know, I think because of the fact that this is a very strongly flavored ingredient, the dried fish, I think it's kind of imparted its flavor to the drumstick as well. But if you love dried fish, if you love your fish, the flavor of your fish very strong, definitely a dish to taste. The dried fish, Tarawan. So this is a para kolombo. Definitely a very meaty fish. It's big in terms of its texture. So what do you typically eat this with? With rice?
With rice.
More taste the Shankara, which was just prepared. Salom, you want to taste some as well?
Mm.
Hot? Very tasty. Very tasty. So the prawn tofu is finally ready and I can't wait to taste this. Even Selvan can't wait to taste this. It's his favorite dish. I love the sweetness of the prawn, with the combination with the tomato and the onion. That beautiful thick masala. Delicious. This is beautiful. Eat it with the masala, with a bit of the curry leaf. Super. Super. So you got a masala being prepared for the dry fish. So this is the karwadu, the fish going to go into the masala there. So what's interesting about the karwadu is that it is, it is a fish that is not sold in the market. So the fishermen take the fish, they dry it, and it is then used when fish is not in season. And so that's when they make a gravy or maybe a tokku out of it. So it's been reconstituted in water, it's been soaked in water, and it is dried and then put into the masala. So this is made of the sea bass. So you can make a karwad with almost anything. Any fish that can be dried.
Whilst I've enjoyed many a seafood meals before, lunch at Selvam's was truly special. Fresh seafood, simple preparations, each unique in its flavor, and most importantly served with a whole lot of love. I was humbled by the generosity and grateful for this experience.
So it's been yet another special episode of the Gourmet Biker, exploring local seafood off the coast of Chennai on the East Coast Road, and more specifically in the tiny fishing village of Kovalam. We've looked at seafood at both ends of the spectrum. We've looked at a chef's commitment to procuring local seafood and creating marvelous regional delicacies with them. And at the other end of the spectrum, we've looked at the way of life for a fisherman. We've gained an insight into the day-to-day life of a fisherman and also a sense of the community. We've looked at the struggles that they faced to bring that glorious seafood to our tables. I hope you've enjoyed this episode of the Gourmet Biker as well. And until the next one, stay safe. Goodbye.